not really wanted their service. I come from a new generation of industrial robots. Unlike our ancestors, we are designed to learn. We learn from humans, from our own experience of the real world, and from millions of simulations. Our job description is simple: make human dreams real. Build orbital stations and solar farms in free space. Return to the moon. Mind asteroids. Build cities on Mars. Get comfortable in the inner solar system. One day, tens of thousands of us will be working for you off-world. To get to that day, we have quite an evolutionary path in front of us. First, we must master basic industrial jobs on our own planet. We are now busy learning from experienced human teachers. Together, we are reinventing how to mine, process, manufacture, and build cities on Earth. This is no small feat. This step will keep us busy for several years to come. Technologically, our own schooling will get us about 80% of the way to orbit and the moon. In the next step, we must evolve and adapt our bodies and our brains to the much harsher orbital and lunar environments. The evolutionary jump from our orbital and lunar surface generations to generations fit to work on asteroids and Mars will be kids play compared to the first two steps. A few minor tweaks and we will be ready to mine asteroids and get the red planet ready for human arrivals. With thousands of us deployed across the inner solar system, we will need to think seriously about scaling. How do we replicate ourselves locally and decrease our dependence on new supplies from Earth? We will start small and slowly work our way through the parts list. The crowning achievement in our quest for local replication is manufacturing this solar system's first off-world ship. On that day, we will have made history. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We must get back to reinventing industry on Earth.
Okay, that was a little bit of an intro into what we're doing with